Welcome back to the Gratuitous Sets Laboratories. So I'm kind of the new guy here, and they gave me a really easy project to start out with, rebuilding this giant CNC machine. Over the coming days and weeks ahead, we're gonna be gutting out this entire machine, giving it a really good scrub down. There's a lot of debris and dust and random stuff that's found its way into all the cavities. So we're gonna be redoing a bunch of that stuff. Replacing a ton of electronics. There's a lot of stuff left over from back in the 90s when this thing was built. Not so current anymore. Yeah, just really kind of doing a ground up restoration of this machine. So as we go back into the cabinet and start building all of the electronics back, somewhat in the way that they were there before, but out of new components, we're gonna be laying everything out new, and we'll probably actually mock up all of the components here on the surface of the table, connect all of the stepper motors together, all the motor drivers, and make sure that it all works and everything's talking to each other. Luckily, with CNC becoming a lot more accessible, we do have quite a few components that we've been able to source from the internet, and everything is much smaller than it used to be, so we're actually gonna take up just a tiny portion of the cabinet that the electronics lived in before. As we're putting together the sort of the central nervous system of this machine, we're actually gonna try and test some of the old components that were still inside the machine. So this machine came with two really nice Italian-made spindle motors, both 4-horse apiece, and we're not entirely certain if they actually function or not. So we're gonna be testing those with our new motor controllers whenever we get those in. These two motors were actually chained together, and not sure exactly if that was for machining multiple parts at one time or doing multiple passes with different tooling. But because they take up so much space on the gantry, we're actually going to pare that down to one spindle motor and just run the one. So between the two spindle motors, we're hoping to get one nice functional motor out of that. We'll also be testing the motor drivers, the original ones from the 90s, to see if those will actually still function. So that's gonna be pretty fun. We do have a few spares, so maybe we can get a functioning set of that. From there down, it's really going to be all new components, new breakout board, new power supplies, everything straight off the shelf. This machine has this really nice giant vacuum table, actually, where you can hold down sheet material and all sorts of things with this giant vacuum pump that we've got over in the corner of the shop. So that vacuum pump is actually going to have some work done to it. I believe it needs bearings and not sure what all, so we may have to open that up and kind of see what it looks like inside. And then this giant phenolic top is going to have to be replaced because it does have a fair bit of damage up on the one end there. So we're going to be sourcing a piece of 1-inch thick phenolic from somewhere and actually having it milled with this checkerboard pattern on a larger CNC machine so that the channels for all of the vacuum will function properly and we should have a brand new surface to be working on. So we have a home for this that it'll eventually move over into this side of the shop over by where the old CNC machine is. Things will probably all get shuffled around over there a fair bit and we'll be running a new dust collection hose up over the top of the machine so that we can kind of access the whole area over the top and keep the dust down. It's actually going to be pretty fun to move this thing over into that corner because it's pretty heavy. So that should be a lot of action on its own. Once we get the entire machine assembled, moved over, all of our components tested and functioning, we will begin our calibration protocols. So we'll make sure that everything is really good and square and straight. So we want to make sure that this thing carves proper dimension and that all of the angles come out right. Nothing worse than trying to make a circle and coming out with an ellipse instead. Hope you find this series to be enjoyable. Hopefully we'll learn something along the way and we'll see you soon.